it's very, very important that, as Tita said, this, the front line of this struggle is every single day, wherever we are. It's very, very important to shift that narrative. In, if we do that with each other, if we do that out in the world, if we do that in the media, if we do that internationally, if we do that in the places of these power, of these, where these decisions are being made. Right now, I work with a lot of students from the University of California who are working on their end of that narrative with their Board of Regents to shift that away, because if the University of California pulls out, TMT is done.
To hear from as many speakers as possible during this session, the Regents do not use these public comment periods for an exchange with speakers. Any questions they have resulting from your comments will be referred to appropriate staff.
Puanani, please proceed with your comment.
Aloha mai kako, o Puanani ko inoa. Hello, Regents. Thank you for this opportunity to make comments. I'm calling to address Agenda Item P4 regarding the federal government relations update. I stand with the UCSA in advocating for doubling the maximum federal Pell Grant to $13,000. However, I do not agree with the UC's use of federal funds to continue your involvement in the 30-meter telescope on Mauna Kea, which the UC is pursuing through new funding from the National Science Foundation. I'm writing to remind the UC that TMT will never be built on Mauna Kea, and will be met with fierce opposition every step of the way if it moves forward on that sacred land. As the University of Hawaii Regents were here at their meeting this week, over 500 comments were submitted last month in opposition to the UH's Mauna Kea Master Plan because it included TMT. Native Hawaiians made their position clear when we stood on the front lines in the thousands for more than 8 months to stop the desecration of their most sacred land. It is a shame that UC is seeking federal funding from the National Science Foundation instead of pulling out of this project completely, clearly prioritizing money over Indigenous rights. Please pull out of the TMT project immediately. Thank you for your time.
We're here at the UCSF Board of Regents meeting for the University of California with the students, the United Students. And we're going to talk to some of them, starting with Dante, who's been organizing for quite a while.
Aloha, everyone. My name is Dante Gonzalez, and I am a UC Berkeley graduate and a student of the University of California. I'm here today on behalf of other UC students. You know, ever since we've been organizing back since 2018, we are still going to be out here today saying every single day that we stand for the Mauna. Okay, as UC students, we're not going to be made complicit to this investment, the violence that has already happened. As UC students, as we're trying to struggle right now for housing, for food security, for resources to the astronomy department that they have right now. They're not even supporting their own astronomy department, but they're gonna put $68 million into a telescope that's already gonna be desecrating sacred land, and we will not be there for it. There's so many things that are wrong with this UC, and if they wanna be on the right side of history or have any little bit of marking in which they can make this change, they should immediately be divesting from the 30-meter telescope and opposing any bit of construction, opposing the grant from NSF, opposing any bit of the master plan draft from the University of Hawaii as well too.
Mahalo, Dante, mahalo. Okay, let's go to Diana. You gave a great comment today, mahalo.
Hello, Regents. My name is Diana Garcia, a recent UCSB graduate, and I'm here with others who oppose the desecration of the sacred Mauna Kea that you, the Board of Regents, are complicit in if you continue your involvement with TMT. We want to remind you all that we will continue to show up and speak at these meetings until you divest from TMT and hold other TMT partners, such as the University of Hawaii, accountable by asking them to step down from the project as well. University of Hawaii has released its Mauna Kea Master Plan draft, mentioning plans for TMT despite the master lease ending in 2033 and uncertainty around the extension of this lease. This master plan draft is a blatant disregard to Native Hawaiian sovereignty as it calls for the creation of a gate that would block off Kanaka Maoli's ability from accessing their sacred mountain. If you continue to fund this project, you're complicit in this colonial violence. TMT will never be built on Mauna Kea. Opposition will continue to grow stronger and louder. Please make the right decision and divest immediately. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Diana. I'm here again, like with the outside of the UCSF Board of Regents meeting. And I'm just here to tell y'all that we're out here in solidarity with UH students who are also showing out at UH, who has also been complicit in colonial violence with Kanaka Maoli, and especially with the recent UH Mauna Kea master plan draft. And we're here to tell the UC to hold UH accountable, as UH is also a TMT partner, and the new UH master plan has mentioned a gate that would block Kanaka Maoli's access to the Mauna, which is direct violation of Indigenous sovereignty. So we're here to tell UH and UC to divest from this project and immediately return these lands. Thank you.
Mahalo, mahalo. Okay, who would like to call? Oh.
The Kuang Talangva relatives, good morning. My name is Morgan. I am here standing with my Hawaiian relatives to stand in solidarity and to let the University of California and the University of Hawaii and the National Science Foundation and all the colonial systems who are colluding together to further desecrate sacred lands. We are still here, no matter how much of government policy they've done to erase us and to destroy our lands. We're still connected to the Aina, to our land, and we need to stand together now more than ever. So this is my call onto all of our relatives to stand together at a time when we need to protect the world, because this is the only world we have. We have no planet B. And that's what the university and the astronomy, their goal is. They are looking to explore exoplanets so they can have a planet B. But this is our only world. There's no promise of a planet B. And even if they did, who do you think they would allow onto that? Only the rich. So let's stand together and let the UC UH know that to divest from this colonial violence. We need everyone here standing. So I hope this reaches your heart. And I hope you know that even listening and tuning in to this live means more than you know, and you can find out more information on how the UC Divest TMT campaign has been showing up at every Board of Regents with the UC, there even during the pandemic, to make public comment, make written comment, to urge the UC Board of Regents to divest from this from the 30 meter telescope. You can find out more information at UNR. If you follow UNR California on Instagram, and on the uprootedandrising.com, there's a UC Divest TMT tab where you can find out and learn more information. And please do not be afraid to reach out and ask. That's all it is. Take a healthy risk. Take a healthy risk and ask. It's okay. Please, we're more than welcoming. Thank
mahalo,
you.
Mahalo. And you folks are planning to also attend the January meeting, yeah?
Correct.
That's when
we plan to gather in large numbers to show up at the January Board of Regents meeting on the 17th and 18th of January.
18th to the 20th.
Yeah, so we got word that there most likely will be a discussion item coming to the Board of Regents, the first one that's come ever since July 2020 regarding the 30-meter telescope. And so we really want to show out students, folks who are part of our coalition across multiple student issues as well too, and really send a very clear message that we are still very much here. Ever since the results of the Astrodecadal Survey and what's being put forward in the master plan draft by the University of Hawaii, we are being slowly continually silenced of our message, and their ambiguity around the concept of finding consent, is already misguided, and they're using it to tailor to their own arguments and to basically justify all of the acts of colonial violence that they want to push forward with this project. And so we are not only going to be breaking apart the false narrative of University of Hawaii being this good steward that they play themselves out to be with this master plan draft, but we're also pushing back on the very notion of how they're trying to go about to find consent when in reality they're just doing consultation so that they can get exactly what they want. want, you know. And consent is justified on the basis of if anyone is pushing back on this issue, then that's not consent. So right then and there, that should be their answer. And we hope that they take not only the university students who are telling you to stop that, not only the community members who are over here in the, on the continent as well too, and also our Kanaka who is on Hawaiian Islands as well too, voicing their opposition to this. You know, we're all here, we're all at a united front. We're also here, as Morgan had said too, with the University of Hawaii students who are standing at their Board of Regents giving comment right now. So please just listen to us. You know, that's all we've asked, you know, that's all we've remained on message, and that's exactly what we'll continue to do.
Mahalo, mahalo. All right.
And I just want to add that it begins with the University of Hawaii returning the rightful stewardship to the Kanaka Ma'ali, where they can further protect what is sacred to them. And it begins with the UC Board of Regents divesting from the TMT.
Morning.
That's what I was
going to
say.
Mahalo. Mahalo. Okay, would you like to,
Katie, yeah.
Mahalo, Katie.
Hi, my name is Katie. I'm a student at UC Berkeley, and I'm a newcomer to this struggle, but I see the ways that it connects to other struggles, as Dante was mentioning, not only within the sphere of the university, but outside as well, throughout the Bay Area and beyond, in that it is a struggle of the people to unite against oppression and violence and transform the world and the society that we're now living in into something where we can all flourish, a world where our children and grandchildren will thrive together. And I think sometimes we do have to see that struggle as a struggle against these people in the boardroom, against the administrators of the university, but in equal measure and perhaps in greater measure, we have to see it as a struggle to unite ourselves, to work together amongst ourselves, which is can be such a great challenge, but it will be what's required if we want to get to that place of harmony and cooperation that we all so desperately hunger for, I think. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Mahalo, Katie.
Kukia imana.
Kukia imana. All right. Melissa, would you like to add something?
You know, the things that I remember that I hold with me daily is so many sayings that I heard throughout, you know, the time on the mauna, where we are the mauna, and just how important it is to care for ourselves so that we can show up and be there for each other. And I'm just so honored and grateful to be here with everyone today. And I'm so proud of everyone for standing up and speaking to the Board of Regents, because I know how difficult it can be. They literally make it as hard as it can be, almost, you know? It's like, do you really want to hear
what
the people are trying to say? So, especially, I'm just really proud of everyone for continuing to stand.
Mahalo. Mahalo. And Melissa's been part of the core organizing too, and we really appreciate all of you folks so much. Well, all the way in Hawaii, we really feel the aloha. Okay, Unko Liko.
As this development goes forward and our full attention is focused on telescopes on Mauna Kea, at the same time, more people are moving to the Hawaiian Islands, and they are not in touch with the natural resources there. Okay, I know to the Lahui up here, they come, we have kumuhulas all over, we've been in an exodus position. But part of what the message here is that Hawaii is still our country. The three letters that Laulani shared last night, which actually prompted the regents to actually call us, because we were just going to be outside holding signs. One of them addresses Alfred Desaias, 40 years at the Office of High Commissioner of Human Rights. He knows the whole story on Hawaii, the incarceration records, every situation. I know he has reviewed. In 2018, he sent a letter to the United Nations Secretary General Guterres and all of the members, notifying them of the application of international law in the Hawaiian Islands. Okay, that is one of the letters that the Board of Regents received. Because, so the other one has to do with identifying the core issues. Where is the root of the problem? There are many problems that come in, but the root of it is that Hawaiian Islands are a country unto themselves, and they needs to be respected that way. It's time to bring out the honesty in America that Queen Liliuokalani pleaded for in 1893. She was pleading, where is the honest American? And that is what I hear and I feel and I see today in your generation. In my heart, we need honesty. When you have science without good faith, you do not have peace. I know that University of Hawaii, you've gone up on the mountain, you have not been listening to the people and taking advantage of the people at home. It's apartheid over there. I've waited a long time. I've been kept alive for this time. Okay, and just we have a lot to express amongst each other. And your generation, express it and tell it and sing it and keep it going, because time is on your side.
Mahalo. I'm gonna stop this live stream because I'm running out of battery and I gotta plug in somehow. but we just want to really mahalo everybody. The UNR live stream is still continuing. This is on Instagram, right?
What's that?
Okay.
Yeah, so for all of our folks, once again, you know, follow our Instagram at unrcalifornia. But UC Divest TMT's team also just wants to share some love and to all of our kapuna who are having their trials coming up soon as well. We're watching vigilantly and we want to just send our love and support on that as well too. Mahalo, thank you so much.
Okay, mahalo everybody. Aloha.
So we are here, there's the students going in. We're going, they are heading in to testify the second day at the University of California Board of Regents. Unko Liko and Morgan are getting ready to do their testimony. And we're passing the high security. Mahalo. Good morning. There's a lot of security to go into this building, but please tune in because we will be having updates. So this is just a preview to say, please stay tuned because there's more to come. And there's also the UH Board of Regents today at 9 a.m. Hawaii time, 11 a.m. California time. So please do stay tuned. We got people outside, people inside, and it's early in the morning. In the morning, but we're ready to go.
Yes.
Okay. So I'm gonna leave to help Unko Liko, and we'll be back. We are at the UC Board of Regents, outside the UC Board of Regents, and we are listening to the testimony. So far, they have not called any Mauna people, even though we have a bunch of people inside the Board of Regents, including Unko Liko, whose name they called yesterday, but they didn't hear his testimony.
I actually have six more people who signed up this morning, plus a couple who are here in person now. So I'm going to call the final six names, plus go back to one who is now in the room. Taryn Damore, Colm Fitzgerald, Laulani Teal, Liko Martin.
Because they had detained him because they wanted to have some additional information from his COVID screening questionnaire. Hopefully Unko Liko will be able to testify. I am not going in because for medical reasons.
Laulani, please proceed with your comment.
Aloha. Aloha, Board of Regents. Thank you so much for hearing me. This is Laulani Teal from the Ho'opaipono Peace Project, and I am here in San Francisco. However, I am choosing to remain outside for health precautions because I'm very concerned with the COVID spread. I want to thank you, and I strongly encourage you to please, at this time, more than ever, please consider divesting from the TMT project in the name of peace. And I want to be really clear that you may hear a lot about the Mauna Kea management plan that was proposed recently by the University of Hawaii and also the decadal survey. Both of those call for community benefits packages, which basically compensate the community with money for the destruction of our sacred mountain. That I want to emphasize how problematic that is. So please, that, you know, when that is done, it in itself is very destructive to communities, destroys the health, the well-being, and creates a lot of conflict and division. It's a colonial paradigm that has gone on for a very long time and all over the world. I ask you not to participate in it and instead to lead the University of California in a better paradigm for science and indigenous peoples. Mahalo.
And they didn't, by the time he walked up from where they were detaining him, they had moved on and closed public comment. So we're kind of thinking they better call him today. So he's inside. You can tune into the UC Board of Regents page. Go check the Mauna Kea live feed. It will be going live on Protect Mauna Kea page. But we are checking for comments.
The matriarch. She provided food for them and protected them from storms. Mauna Kea them, taught them life ways, and still teaches them spiritual and navigational wisdom. When as adults, Mauna Kea called out to families to speak in protection for her, the families answered. Protecting Mauna Kea from the construction of 30-meter telescope is a rallying stand because TMT is an example of the historical and current injustices affecting Native Hawaiians from colonial research. Listen to Native Hawaiians. Halt budgeting for TMT. Thank you, and please stay safe.
Yay, Auntie. Mahalo.
Okay, let me call the remaining folks I haven't called yet. I think they should be in the room, I hope. Liko Martin, Arsenega, Dante Gonzalez, Morgan Temche.
Yay, we just want to mahalo all these students who are students and supporters who've come out to hold space. So there's a lot of different kinds of comment that are happening, and you know, they're testifying on many subjects, and they're kind of they're not necessarily taking all of the Mauna testimony, but they are you know, our speakers are going to largely close it out, it looks like.
Good morning. My name is Jeff Durow, and I am the Council of UC Staff Assembly Delegate for UC Riverside.
Thank you. Those are all of our speakers on the phone, and I believe our remaining speakers are now in the room. So any order you'd like to speak, just come on up to the microphone. And if you weren't, you probably weren't in the room when I went over the guidelines, so you'll have up to a minute.
Good morning, Board of Regents. My name is Liko Ohlone Martin. I am one of the 37 elders that was arrested on Mauna Kea, still awaiting trial. And My comments are regarding science, faith, and peace, and the necessity to have efficiency and integrity in the conduct of business here. And with respect to the construction of the TMT, that is a specific site on the northeast face of Mauna Kea, 500 feet below the summit. That is pristine. It is the water collection shed for the entire watersheds of the North Mountains of Kohala and the whole northeast side of the Big Island. It is untouched, it is unblemished, and as the Mauna Kea Management Report has indicated, that it won't be seen. It's not a matter of being seen. It's a matter of its specific location, and I think prior to any determinations to build the prior telescopes, that area was designated as very sacred. There are burials there, untouched burials of skeletal remains that are at least 8, maybe 10 feet long. It sits exactly in the area of the Ring of Shrines, which circles the summit of Mauna Kea.
Time.
From this particular location, you can look down into the crater of Haleakala and see the entire slope, the chain of islands going all the way up on a clear day to Poliahu Heiau, which is the cousin to the summit Poliahu on the island of Kauai.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yay, Unko Liko. All right. Morgan. There's Morgan. Hopi Sista. Awesome organizer.
Nakwang Talongva UC Board of Regents. Nitiponi Hopian Matua. Nit Musang Navmana Nitbatna Wungwa. My Hopi name roughly translates in English as sacred bundle. I come from the village of Musang Navi and am born into the Squash Blossom Clan. I am here to let you know that I am the product of ancestral love, prayer, and resilience. I exist today because my ancestors resisted, so I will resist. I am here in solidarity with all of our Kanaka Ma'ali relatives who are protecting what is most sacred, Mana Aupakea. And I am here to urge the UC Board of Regents to divest from the construction of the 30-meter telescope. I remember stories from my people of times when they have come to people of power such as yourselves to plead not to go forward with the desecration of what is sacred. And it is though those times have not changed, because here I am today. I want to make it very clear I am not in opposition to science. I am in opposition to the continuation of settler colonial violence that continues to perpetuate the erasure of Aboriginal people. I urge the UC to transform beyond greed. To build on the sacred is to desecrate the sacred. And I would like to end with a quote from Dr. Uahakea Mali, that the conquest of outer space is dependent on the conquest of the indigenous peoples on this planet, in our spaces, whether that be Wet'suwet'en or Hawaii. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Morgan! Wee-haw! Dante!
Good morning, Board of Regents. My name is Dante Gonzalez, and as a graduate from the University of California, Berkeley, I'm standing here today also to condemn UC's investment in the 30-meter telescope. As partners have most likely told you, it's near impossible to determine consent for this project. Community outreach from NSF, UH, and other government agencies present consent as an impossible task to achieve, and to a certain extent, they are correct. There is no monolith, there is no one voice. But when we think about the meaning of consent, any resistance means no, and therefore there is not consent, and that's simple. You're hearing this resistance today, and I hope that you move forward with that mindset and intention and see this manufactured consent that is being perpetuated by these agencies and your partners. Kia'ia and the Mauna made their message clear, and they will not budge to future construction. Students alongside them will act in that same manner. We also stand here today in solidarity with the students who are also giving similar comment as we speak at the University of Hawaii against the TMT and the false narratives presented by UH. The UH master plan proposal contains a stipulation to block off the access road, and that is a direct challenge to indigenous cultural practitioning. Finally, we know the results of the Astrodictatal Survey recommend TMT be funded, and the NSF will most likely be in that decision, but you ultimately have the power to change that course of action and put a halt to TMT. You have that power, and our coalition of UC students and community members will hold you accountable to using that power. We will be in touch soon, and hope that you take our invitation to discuss these matters further. Thank you.
Kukia'i mauna!
Kukia'i mauna!
Thank you very much.
All right, Dante.
You joined us in person and on the phone. Appreciate your comments.
Yeah! All right, Kukia'i mauna! Yeah! Awesome job! Well, I think that was a good... pretty good testimony there, yeah. So this is a double header day. There's the UC Board of Regents and the UH Board of Regents in one day. Guys are all here for us. How sweet. They take security seriously around here for these activist people who might show up. Anyway, that's the University of California. So now they're giving the UH president's message.
Even our traditional students, when they take online courses,
apparently finished public comment, which was only like a couple of people that didn't seem to be
graduation statistics.
Was super short. It was while we were just standing here. That was the public comment. So far, the University of California is actually winning the legitimacy award. Yeah, the due process award. Because the University of Hawaii just fails. And that's why the University of California should be distancing themselves from this. Because this is what the process looks like. They throw up a meeting. They had it, this Board of Regents meeting. They only announced it 48 hours ago, right? Which is the legal requirement. Didn't probably publicize it. Then they invited everybody to sign up for comment. A bunch of us registered. Then I get an email saying that we're successfully registered. And then they send another email at the beginning of the meeting saying that my registration has been canceled with no explanation whatsoever. And now, and then they throw up a few people to speak, right, who are giving public comment, right?
Yeah.
Now David Lasner is giving his presentation, which will include the decadal survey on astronomy.
So we're going to tune in for that, right?
We might as well hear this.
Throughout the state. I did get a question from a region.
The UC was... at least heard us. UH, on the other hand, University of Hawaii, is currently, as we speak, having a Board of Regents meeting that is not one of their regular scheduled meetings. It was apparently added on, we don't know when, but it was put up so that David Lasner, President David Lasner, could give this presentation that he is now giving on the state of affairs at UH, including the decadal survey as it relates to TMT. So, you know, which has to do with National Science Foundation funding for TMT, right? There was a public comment period at the beginning of this session, which many of us signed up for. And we did the registration, we gave our information, we received emails back saying that our registration was confirmed, and then I received another email saying that my registration was canceled. So they canceled the registrations.
take security seriously around here for these activist people who might show up. Anyway, that's the University of California. Back to the University of Hawaii. So they canceled all of the testimony for Mauna Kea. As far as I could see, we had it up. We didn't see any public testimony at all. And many people signed up to testify.
They're making the appearance that there would be public participation. You know, there was a big call out for public participation. This same thing happened just a couple of weeks ago for the Mauna Kea Master Plan presentation. So they've been doing this fairly consistently. I mean, I could say it was a technical glitch or a simple error if it happened once, maybe, but it hasn't happened once. It's happened many times. And for people who don't know, such as the other TMT partners, the science community, worldwide, international observers, unless we are able to speak individually to these people and tell them what is going on in a way that they will actually believe, the official record makes them look pretty good. It makes them look like they're reaching out, giving opportunities for comment. It's just that none of those are real. They're all fake. And this is really kind of serious. So anyway, just letting people know that that is what is going on. But we've had a pretty full day from early morning here at the University of California, here at the UCSF Rudder Center, where the UC Board of Regents met this morning, and we had some great testimony go forward at this meeting. And yesterday too, I was able to testify yesterday. Diana here, who's been an awesome voice of the UC students, was able to testify, and we've just had some just terrific people today. We had Unko Liko, Dante, Morgan. We've had really, really terrific people speaking. So mahalo to the University of California. At least they're listening. And by the way, please tune in to that in January, because they're going to meet again, and their student regents, they have two students who sit on the Board of Regents of the University of California, and their student regents are for real, and they're really good people. And we really thank them, because they're very aware, and they're really speaking for the students who are saying no to TMT, and, you know, frankly, who need them. Okay. Let's check it out.
Astro 2020, I believe, for the first time, explicitly recognizes the concerns of many Native Hawaiians regarding astronomy and TMT, in particular, on Mauna Kea.
Our voices speak for the land, and as we speak for the land, every effort is being made to silence us. Every effort is being made to encapsulate our voice. And really, if you look at the master plan that was put out, they call it e'o i ka leo. It's singular. They're not listening. They translate it as listening to the voice. Well, they're listening to a singular voice, and it's not ours. Apparently, there was a pro TMT testifier earlier.
So there's a lot of opportunity for us.
I mean, he keeps mentioning somebody who like
talked earlier,
but I didn't see that.
Example, I didn't see that either.
The second one is the Build Back Better Act.
He can't help himself from staying engaged in getting the money for
reconciliation proposal.
So these money sources might be interesting information, because there might be people to speak to.
Every week, the provisions for free community college have been dropped, but
Never mind that.
language teachers in Native American languages, including Hawaiian. There will be, we believe, a significant grant program for college retention and completion.
One of the problems with significant in Hawaiian language is
minority-serving institutions.
They often
all 10 of our campuses are
have
classified as
Hawaiian,
such.
Invest in Hawaiian language, cut off from anything
from
related
the,
to sovereignty or land, you know. Yeah,
again,
specifically, like TMT invests heavily in Hawaiian language programs. Heavily
given our affinity with
in
them.
Children's language programs, in community
commerce,
language programs. And, you know, these are programs that are, of course, hurting for money, right?
Mm-hmm. For, again,
so you're going to bring all this money in, it creates division.
And
you get Hawaiians fighting Hawaiians and not fighting them, you know, like they win, right?
Yeah. Research, education,
yeah, so that's,
job training,
that's been their strategy. They love to fund
like
language.
Mm-hmm. Pathways to practice.
Yeah,
we're hoping
exactly.
for help on assuming that bill, that better bill, makes it through.
Okay, this
the
can...
The last of the three bills I want to mention
is
the federal budget bill in the current drafts. I don't think it's worth our time to go through those now. We'll keep you updated if you are interested.
It's definitely not worth our time. But everybody here is standing strong, so it's good that we're able to tune in here so we can see that, you know, here we have the University of California and the University of Hawaii are both doing their thing, you know, but the people... The people of Hawaii, the people that live in California, uprooted and rising, you know, the indigenous peoples of this land, all these people are standing together, and we're all saying the same thing, a'ole, you know, and no means no. It doesn't matter if it's like, you know, a date or a sacred place. When you say, when a person says no, when people say no, it means no, period. It's very, actually a very simple concept, but apparently really hard to understand. So David Lasner is talking about many different things, but we are here standing strong. I just really want to mahalo.
Well, I'm thinking that the important thing, Laulani, is what I'm listening to Mr. Lasner.
Mm-hmm.
He's saying, he's talking about, again, when you have bad science, then you most likely will have the lack of good faith.
Mm.
And when Mr. Lasner speaks of the non-contiguous states, see, this is bad political science. Mr. Lasner, you're lying to yourself. Okay? You know history. Apartheid in the Hawaiian Islands. Why has the, as an example, why have the university's experimental stations in agriculture gone defunct? Because they didn't want them to affect the Hawaiian people. They wanted the information and the research for themselves, for their private enterprises.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, which in the context now equates to never mind the taro patches.
Mm-hmm.
Why aren't the taro patches, example, on Kauai up and running, the 3,000 acres? Why is the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission giving money for a water diversion program right over mm-hmm. there by the experimental station run by the university? Why is there more money coming in through the decadal thing to build courts? Courts for what? Courts for incarceration. Okay, and the plundering that is occurring through the judicial systems of the United States and the state of Hawaii. For Mr. Lasner, you should become on par with Dr. Alfred Desaias, whose report in 2018 has been submitted to the United Nations, calling for an immediate investigation and intervention into the genocidal policies an administration that is happening in the Hawaiian Islands. This all sounds really great, but we already have, what happens to all the tourist money? Where is the money going that's coming out of Hawaiian Islands? It's not coming into Hawaii. So they're going to the United States Congress and begging them for money, when they can't even give the money, the rent that is overdue to the Hawaiian people, mm-hmm. under the trust arrangement. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, and I know Lasna and them, they do not want to talk about this. Yeah. But that is the fact. So you listen to Lasner, his great spiel. It's all smooth. I've heard it all before. But why are the people in the streets? Why is Hawaii, Hawaii's people, the largest per capita homeless under the Stars and Stripes? Why is it like that? It's called neglect. Not just ordinary neglect. It's called wanton neglect.
And abuse.
And the abuse of power, abuse, misadministration, malfeasance, the misprision of felonies, you got it all. So as I'm listening to this gentleman who's the president, it's just like going to somebody's sermon. It's like going back in history and having the United Church of Christ say, well, you know, these savages, they couldn't run their country in the first place. So we're here to do it better. That's the sickness in the narrative here. You're gonna teach us language. This is like Dan Inouye on August 26, 1988, and Kekuni Blaisdell is and Inouye is up there, and he say, well, to Kekuni, well, you have your language, don't you? And Kekuni looks at him in astonishment. We need our land. We need our land. The indigenous people need their lands given carte blanche to them and stop taking them. If you can't take the land, you divert the water. If you can't do the thing, you make it not rain. That's bad science. You can't get good faith out of bad science, and neither can you get peace. The problem with the Decadal study is that it's enforcing the militarization of the Hawaiian Islands, which is a country unto its own. So academia is very dumb, I'll say that, okay? It's just forgetting history. They're being ignorant of it, and that is a dangerous thing to do. It's disgusting. I mean, I wish you could play ping pong with this gentleman. You know, fastball, fast game of ping pong, you know? Because what's going to be left? You don't realize that this telescope will destroy the entire watershed into Kohala. The water's going into Kohala. It's already that the Mauna Kea Beach Hotel has already taken the waters out. Laupohoihoi Basin, the river stream, everything comes from exactly, it starts to form where that 500-foot plateau. Good, Lasner. And Science Foundation, get those telescopes off of there. Give some people some jobs. But not at the expense of looking for the creation of the world while you're going to build something on a place that is maintaining the creation of the world. This world.
Yeah.
The world that we need.
Yeah.
Okay, jobs. We were quite busy with our jobs. Our job was our lifestyle. Our religion is living with the natural resources. Okay? In the apology law, they refer to, oh, we make an apology to the Hawaiian kingdom and its indigenous people. That is a total insult. If you say indigenous and you're going to recognize our titles and rights, vested interests, that's another thing. But just throw us and say, because if you come to Hawaii now, you will not find one village, my friends. Not one village. Indigenous is a bogus word in Hawaii. Don't call us indigenous. Call us the nationals,
the people who have held the fight and held the ground for 128 years and have been waiting for the honest American, which I can see Mr. Lazar is not an honest American because he is not being honest about history.
Yeah.
You can't be honest about history, then you're off on another planet, Mr. Lazar. Maybe you're the one who should go up with Bezos and they'll drop you off out in outer space someplace. No, really, take a ride.
Take a couple light years to your next planet.
Okay, so this is what we're facing with. Why are there 500,000 Hawaiian families over here, up here in the mainland? Because we've been listening to the same kind of rhetoric that I'm listening to on the side, and it's just annoying, okay? Why have 500,000 of all of the major population move? Because there's no jobs. What we have in Hawaiian Islands is apartheid, by distinction, meaning they call us Native Hawaiian. They put us on the Native American Indian Native Religious Freedom
Under
Act.
Under them.
Okay? That's Senator Inouye, that's the politicians, that's the people who are representing the people who took over the Hawaiian Kingdom government in 1893. Those are the people who are trying to prop up the flag and forget that they are underneath the United States Constitution because of 1959. And let me remind you, Mr. Lazar, I hope he goes to Washington and I hope maybe he gets a call from the Justice Department. And they'll say, Mr. Lazar, we'd like to talk to you. Now, I mean, you know, I'm kind of getting a little off, but investigation and intervention by the executive branch of the United States government to stop the genocide in the Hawaiian Islands. Stop the complete destruction of the resources. Stop the militarization. You want to play war? What's wrong with you people? Huh? What is wrong? Militarization, the more you build, the more the other side build. Until you're going to have some idiot, like a person who cannot remember their history, who won't be honest. Where is the honesty in this? There's no honesty. No.
Heyo, yeah.
Don't be fooled by it. Don't be fooled. Smooth talk. Yeah, especially with the agriculture, the resources. I mean, you know, the nitrate levels, all of the islands where you have development coming, the nitrate levels from the cesspools, you can't go in the beaches. There are 40,000 permits right now for houses in the corner coast on the Big Island. 40,000 permits on lands, private lands, of Hawaiian people, their private lands. And nobody can buy a house. Well, they've been kicked off of their land in the first place. Who's coming for those 40,000 permits? It's not gonna be, who is it? You got the David Lazar gang. You got the people who are coming in and saying, sitting over here and going, well, where am I gonna spend my money? Well, we'll just invest. Hawaii seems like a nice place. They've got lots of water. They have nice beaches, yeah. But for people who don't go swimming, for people who don't eat seaweed, who don't eat fish, it's great for them to say, to piss in the well, to say it very bluntly. The TMT would be a matter of billing your outhouse in your kitchen.
Yeah, right. That's
right over your sink.
Yeah.
That's the reality of the TMT, the site where it's going to build it someplace else. Fine. But what that will do to that site and the entire Laupohoehoe, Hamakua site watershed and the Kohala Mountains. If you think it's only trickling now, it'll only get worse. And yes, you have an impoverished, starved community, Hawaiians, yeah? Why is that so? Why? What's wrong? They don't like to work? No, the fact is that they were too busy living their lives with their lifestyle. Rather than going out and getting a job because they relied on the resources to fund themselves. What resources now? I don't see them talking about going and removing all the trees out of the rivers. I don't see them going and retrofitting all the hotels and all the secondary sewage that's being dumped right into the ocean, right off to the left of Waikiki. No. The science is off and there's no good faith. It's just opportunists.
It's only showing like a little.
So this is the after UC, during UH gang. Okay, might as well hold it up. Yeah. So right on. It's highly militarized situation here. But there are a bunch of students all testifying for the protection of Mauna Kea, and they're doing an awesome job. The University of California students have been super, super wonderful.
As I'm traveling from place to place, some familiar and some
together. Stands together, and
generation, to the of our generations.